Hi everyone, it's Kel and Rich. We're back with you. Thanks so much for joining us. My name's Rich. This is my wife, Kel.
Hi there, welcome.
And we love providing first reaction videos to everyone, metal all the way to progressive rock, anything in between, that's awesome. So I'm a former musician, big time music appreciator, brought that appreciation to my children. One of my children actually passed away 5 months ago, 6 months ago. His name is Jared. That's his guitar. It's always between us. That's a flying V Jackson King. And now Kel is my partner in crime, as they say, and we're having a really good time.
My name's Kel, and I, contrary to popular belief, about 95% of the music that we react to, I have never heard. I led a really sheltered life, and I was focused on my music studies. I'm a classically trained concert pianist, and I had a music practice, and I just didn't have anybody around me that wanted to listen to that music. So once I broke free of all of those influences and we became friends and then lovers and then married, we've been exploring all kinds of really cool music together, and that's kind of how this channel started after Jared passed away. So when I come home from work, which I just got home, I have no idea what the playlist is for the night. All I know is that I'm coming home to a rock concert.
Judas Priest.
God, I love Judas Priest. We saw them in concert.
Yeah, they were so good. They were so good.
Oh,
so
it was great.
A while back, we did Victim of Changes, and we got a little feedback. And feedback is great, because you're guiding this channel. This channel basically is request-driven. I then choose what we're going to do based on what I know about Kel and what you guys are kind of saying and where we're kind of moving as a community. So, you know, you said the early 80s, that's the best version of Victim of Changes, at least Rob's voice and everything that was going on. So this is from 83, and it's actually, just give me one sec, this is from the U.S. Festival, Glen Helen Park, San Bernardino, California, 1983. It's high def, advanced 1080p, so let's see Judas Priest in the early 80s.
It was so fun to go see them.
Oh, it was so good.
Yeah, it was great.
Even though Rob does look like he's about 104, he's still.
But he rode that motorbike. He rode that Harley out on stage.
Oh yeah.
So that was pretty impressive.
And when Glenn came on stage and did the last two songs.
Yeah.
Unreal.
That's great.
All right, let's make the screen really big. Here we go, Kel.
Indeed, we have a song that takes us way, way, way back to the Sad Wings of Destiny album, also Unleashed in the East. You might know this one. This is Victim of Changes.
He's such a good show machine. Look at that. Nice.
Love that.
We'll be right back.
Sorry. A bit loud, the clapping.
Some things make life so amazing to be living.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
One of those moments. What can you say?
Wow.
Unless you have something really hot on your mind, Kelly.
I just don't. I'm so glad we saw them before they stopped touring. What a gift.
Yeah.
And God, he can still rip it out.
Oh, yeah. He was amazing. He was amazing. Just a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
It was like a month ago.
It's crazy. It was so fun.
I was at a client's house today, and we were doing some great kind of golf-specific training, golf-specific exercises, and some body work and things to just really make him nail that ball and make it so that he has tons of endurance. And after, he took me to his kind of meditation room. He's a subscriber now. He likes our channel. And he played some of his meditation music for me. And he has it on one of the highest quality sound systems that a human being can have. And without getting into the specifics of it, it's that good. Maybe you know that kind of quality of equipment. Four pieces, $30,000. And we're talking amazing stuff. And it's specific for healing and for balancing and things like that. This type of sound system, it does something with the actual processing of the sound in analog, not digital, much better. And he played it for me, and I was zoning out, and we were just having that moment. And watching that just now, same thing for me. It doesn't need to be meditative music. It just needs to be like that. And that's what I'm realizing.
Mm-hmm.
And here's another thing that really caught my attention. One of our regular subscribers explained it like this. Because I asked, what is it about the scream and the intensity and the blood and the death and all the other subject matter in these songs that he likes? What is it that you like about it? He said, because I was dead inside for so long, it was the only thing that brought me out. It's the only thing that made me feel. And I just clicked. It needs to be, for that gentleman, it needs to be extreme. It needed to be, and I get it. What do you think about that? We haven't talked about this. He feels something. He feels something. He cuts himself off.
As a person who has experienced that same reality, which I've spoken about once or twice before, I lived for a long, long time not having any feelings. And it eventually just became normal, which is not normal. And it actually changed when I met you. And I realized that I felt so much better just being around you than when I wasn't around you. And that was when we didn't mm-hmm. even know each other. We were just getting to know each other at that point. Mm-hmm. And I realized that
we worked together.
We had merged our companies. We both had fitness companies. I realized one day that I was just, my happy place was at work with you. And then I began to question all of that, and I realized that there were a whole bunch of changes in my life that I really needed to make, and I started making them, and this music makes me feel the way you make me feel. And I've said it before, you know, being a concert pianist and being in orchestras and symphonies and bands, and I can play lots of instruments and it doesn't even matter, but I never actually enjoyed it. I would smile if everybody did their jobs and it sounded great, or I would smile if I did a good performance or if I did well on my music exams, but I didn't actually have any fun because I was so busy being at work with music that I really, as a child, was not at play with music. I did not play music.
This was
I
also
worked at music.
Into your teens, though. It wasn't just as a child, right?
Yeah, into my teens and into my 20s. Mm-hmm. And so now I'm playing music for the first time. I would always hear music. I would not listen to music. And now I'm listening to music. We're taking time out of every day to stop to listen to music that makes us feel. And I just think, wow, we're so lucky. What gifts we have in this lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
What gifts we have in this lifetime. What gifts we have in this lifetime. But someone said to me today, how come you're this way?
Where did they say that?
Well, in case you're watching, Nicole, this was, I'd rather not say.
No, but on the channel or in person? Or
in
like,
person.
Oh, I see.
And so, hi, Nicole. And she said to me, have you always been this way? And I said that there was a yes, but no mud, no lotus. And some of you on the channel have heard me say that before. So the lotus flower does not grow in water. The lotus blossom starts down in the deep, dark, scudgy mud, which is where it starts, and then it fights its way through the mud, and it goes up the murky, disgusting, swampy water to emerge on top, beautiful, and waiting for the sunshine. And I think that we're all lotus flowers, and some of us have to start in the mud. And that was definitely me. So, I'm happy we have all this music to make me feel, and I'm glad that I can feel. So I hear what you're saying out there.
Mm-hmm.
I know what it's like to live like that. I lived like that for almost 4 decades.
Hmm. I only felt like that at one point in my life. And doesn't matter when it was, just that it was. But I can't say I never felt, but I remember thinking, just make everything stop. Make these bad feelings stop. So I can only understand it cerebrally, what this gentleman said to me, and I can appreciate where he has been, where you have been about not feeling. It just, to me, it was an aha moment, because I'm thinking to myself, because some of the suggestions he gave me, I sampled it because I want to sample it for you, and when it's real extreme stuff, and I'm just like, what the hell is this shit? And then I'm like, what the fuck, man? Like, who listens to this? What is wrong with you? And that was my knee-jerk reaction, as some of us have to stuff that's new or unfamiliar, or we're just, for whatever reason, it just turns us off. That's okay. But I'm coming at it from, okay, there's something for me to learn, just like Kel. When she does something that she doesn't like, it's time to open her ears. There's a saying, which whatever we resist persists. And so I approach it like that, and I looked at the lyrics. I'm like, And I responded back to him, and that's what he said to me. He said it got me to feel. I'm like, okay, well that's one way. I can hit you over the head with a frying pan. That'll make you feel too. And I get it. It's that much of a requirement at that point. And he found it, and it got him through. And now here he is. So whatever the method, awesome. So I'm getting it. I'm learning as we're doing this.
When the internet first came about, most of you remember its inception when we all first started getting an email address and receiving mail online at home versus just on intranets at work. And I started viciously Googling to see if there was some kind of syndrome or something that was tied to not feeling. And I looked for that over the years to see if it was a condition or what was it called, and because I wouldn't classify it as depression, but I just had no feelings. It was just an empty, hollow, walking around, smiling and looking perfect on the outside, and yet on the inside a chasm of nothing. And it was a strange time. So for those of you that have gone through that,
or going through it,
or are going through it, the only thing I can say that helped me is that even though I knew it was not okay, I knew that there was lessons in there that I had to learn, and that I am the me that I am today because I have endured everything that's gone on in my life. And I would not be this person today if it was not for the past that I've lived. Because if I lived a different past and made different choices, it wouldn't make me a better me. It would just make me a different me. I wouldn't be this me, I would be different. So it's not good or bad, it's not better or best, it's not worse or somehow not worse, it's just different. Mm-hmm. So as hard as it is to swallow bitter pills, they build you into what you are in this moment. So whatever you're going through, no matter how dark it is, you're not alone.
Yeah.
Because we've all had darkness. We've all had darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the only way you can identify the light.
Yeah. Keep coming back.
Share with us.
Keep coming back.
In private or...
Keep listening,
there's many
watching.
Wonderful, wonderful souls on this channel. You're all relating to each other in such a fantastic and phenomenal way. And we are just... We feel so privileged to be able to do this with you. And we really thank you for being here because all of you are building this into what it is.
There was something said today that I would like to actually share before we sign off, Kel.
Okay.
And just give me a moment. You guys, thanks for this. I just want to bring it up because it was that significant for me. You know who you are. I'm hooked. Your videos are addictive. I have no words to share how captivating Kel's reactions are and put me in a trance. Enough already. But please don't underestimate your influence on the viewers. So many people want to share their favorite songs with you, and your forum is perfect, completely satisfying.
Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you for blessing us with such high compliments.
And just having the courage and the balls to say that. It really brings us to a very humble place.
Absolutely.
And causes us to realize that what we're doing is important. And we're not really sure how best to go about it, how best to expand. Do we just continue doing what we're doing, knowing that we can get shut down just like that as soon as the fair use, first reactions, using artist music, all of a sudden turns illegal, like fully illegal? Shut down one day, boom, everybody that's doing this gets just...
And lawsuits.
So we must continue to expand outside of what we're doing. And we're still going to do first reactions. But very, very soon, we're going to have a Patreon page and we're going to have other content such as exercise videos, partner massage how-tos, transformational learning, all these other things that we've touched on, because that's the other stuff that Kel and I do. We love listening to music together. Oh my goodness. I love doing this with Kel. You guys saw me. I don't know if she saw me, but I kind of looked up to the stars, looked up to the heavens, said, thank you so much. Look what I get to do with her. And I wish that everybody has a partner or people that they can do that with. And maybe we can find people to do it with if you're in a rural area and nobody likes your type of music.
Yeah.
If your family is all around you and they don't want to listen to your type of music and you're alone watching these videos and thinking, oh man, if I only had a Kel, if I only had a Rich. Well, I think what we're going to be doing with Patreon, it's actually possible.
Yes.
So stay tuned.
There's more coming.
Not meaning to throw a hook and yeah, just keep watching. We're doing it. We're building it. We're figuring it out day by day. And when we launch it, it's going to be spectacular because you guys have created that possibility and that direction for us.
And based on the high level that you're all bringing, we want to give you our best every day.
Absolutely.
And it's a beautiful thing when you can say that to complete strangers that you've never met. You're all awesome.
Yeah, you guys don't really feel like strangers anymore.
No.
Even if you're a new subscriber or you're a new visitor, you don't have to subscribe. But an email comes. It's like, hey, thanks for taking the time. Now, I can't and we can't respond to everything every day because there's too much.
There's too much now.
But we get to it eventually. And
we try.
Yeah. At least I'm going to send you, hey, got your email. Talk to you another time. Too busy. Can't do it. Need more hands. Need to be an octopus.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for watching, you guys. A kiss for good luck. A kiss for love. Good wishes.
Keep on kissing.
Keep kissing.
Keep kissing.
Later.
Bye.